Have a good one. Wait, does Stacy have to go? Oops, our noodles. I want these.
Gotta start my own stream.
I'm actually gonna leave the list because I'm super hungry. Well, it's tacos or days. Whoever enters the room first will probably play.
Gotta start my own stream now.
First on the house, you gotta go for it.
Definitely on stream now. Yeah, yeah. Damn it, can't even rotate my chair. Alright, guys.
A lot of people live in California that come to this year. Oh my gosh.
So, another episode of Tech Skill Tuesdays. So, today we're going to be covering, covered it already. I should probably cover it again. Oh my god, call your mom, please. Oh, right, Ryan, I did
sorry,
to cover it.
I saw your name first. I'm so sorry.
Get started on today's Tech Skill Tuesdays. So today, I forgot to change the title. No, why am I doing this? God damn it. Okay. Alright, we're good. Okay, so now I've officially changed it, scooted out from my desk a little bit, got myself a little more comfortable. Alright guys, so today we're going to be talking about the ledge. Very, very, very important subject. And actually, let me pull up my, my notes. The ledge and everything else pretty much hasn't changed ever since the game has been released. So, what I have here is a little bit old, but, it's still relevant, even today. It has not been touched at all. Oops. Continue. Alright. Alright, so. Covering options from the ledge. So, this is actually a fairly important subject. For those of you who are wanting to pick up Smash, because of course one of the big things, of course, in this game is edgeguarding. So I'll be covering all of the options that we have today. I'll be going over them one by one. The frame data for each character is relatively the same. It doesn't matter what your damage is. I believe it doesn't matter what the damage is. Even if you're over like 100 damage, or actually, here, let's test it out right now. So, there we go. So this is one of the first things that you should know, is that you can grab the ledge while your back is turned to it. So that means you can, if you do the half circle motion on your analog stick, from there to there, depending on where you're facing. The half circle motion, you'll grab the ledge. Or you can just run off and just hold down back. And that's the easy way to do it, but you want to get that nice half circle in, because it will get you onto the ledge faster. And it's something I personally still have to work at as well, so. There we go. Alright, so, going over all the options for the ledge. First off, we have some of the more common ones. I'll be going over them one at a time. So right now, we have attacks. So characters could pretty much get up from the, get up attack from the ledge, and it does have invincibility. On average, usually they last almost a whole second, as you can see right there. Remember, the shield is one frame, so we could use that as like a reliable way to measure how long it takes for a move to end. This is, of course, without taking into account the IASA frames, or Interrupt as Soon as Available frames. So, but this is not too bad. Right, so, for Fox, generally, his getup attack, it has, like, invincibility frames from 1 to, So it has invincibility frame for 17 out of the 55, so if you do choose getup attack, you will get a bit of invincibility, but if they ignore the very initial portion of it, and attack you, even during your attack, you could end up trading with the opponent. Or if you just end up whiffing entirely, like if the opponent outspaces you, like by standing right there, for example. Too close. Fox actually has a really good getup attack. Some characters have really good getup attacks. There we go. That's a really good space. I actually could probably be a little closer. Probably even like right there. There we go. So even when space is far away, they could still cover. Yeah, they will not be able to get you. The other option, and yeah, of course after that, it starts recovering at around frame 38. Oh no, that's how much recovery it has. Ew. Well, that's absolutely disgusting. Then, after the attack, you have 38 frames of recovery where you can't do jack shit. It's kind of horrible. And after that, of course, we have the other options. We have roll onto the stage. Roll onto the stage is also a very, very nice option. Of course, you could use it to roll past attacks and characters. Let's see here, dodge. There we go, for dodge. Of course, not going to be doing any attacks out of it, but let's see. If we're going by frame data, you are invincible. Let's see here. Roll is about 49 frames. And you get invincibility 1 through 28. It does differ from character to character. Some characters do have more invincibility over time, but. As you can see, they generally end around the same area. From there, we have the jump button. Jump button is probably one of the more underrated ones in the game that isn't used as much. 24 frames in total. So, you are invincible. 1 through 12, and then you have a 12 frame active. So, though, I believe it does have IASA frames, so. Not sure with what. Looks like it only can be canceled with specials. I was able to do it with my down B, really. Yes. Yo, Matt. How's it going, man? Glad for you. Glad you could join the lesson today. I'm covering pretty much all the ledge options. And then, I'm gonna be going over ways on how you could punish them. So. Alright, so we have. So we have jump. So jump, let's slow it down, actually. Alright, so jump from the ledge. It has invincibility frames from 1 to 12 frames, so the moment that you let go, till about 12 frames while you're still in the air, you have invincibility. You also, of course, so that covers get-up attacks, which are really, really, really bad in this game, I think. They take a whole second from the very beginning to the very end. They're only active for maybe like a third of the time, and they're only invincible for like a tenth of the time, so even less than that. Like so. Well, I'm doing good, Matt. Glad to see that you could make it to this stream, that you could watch and take in all this information. It's really, really useful. Yo, Corymon, thank you so much for the host. Hope all you guys are able to take a lot from the stream. We're going to be covering ledge options today. We're going to be going over those and, of course, how to punish them. And hopefully this will be able to up you guys' game in Smash. So, I hope you look forward to it. Corymon! Corymon, the fries! Alright. So the first thing, of course, I'm going to be going over all the standard options for the ledge, which is attack, oops, roll, jump, regular getup, and of course the most famous one, ledge jump. And of course the other option and the other two things that are new in particular to the ledge. So if you are grabbing the ledge, and someone grabs onto it afterwards, actually, you could do that. I could demonstrate that here. Oops. Do that, throw her off, wait for a little bit. So that's the other thing. When the opponent gets thrown off, that's another one of the options. And yeah, I'll be going over those. The fries. Oh, now that I think about it, I smell food in my house, and that smells delicious. So, I'll try to make this lesson fairly quick for you guys. So, alright, so we're gonna be going over get up attacks. Get up attacks first. They last on average about 55, so I want you guys to keep in mind that this game is 60 frames per second. So, fry hype. But yeah, this game takes place 60 frames per second. So, whenever you do a get up attack, like so, you're invincible probably for about like 1 to 19 frames. 20 is about the average when I looked at it. Then you attack afterwards, and after that you're completely vulnerable for the rest of the time. So, get up attacks, I think, in general, are not worth it. You're good for about 20 frames, and then for the like remaining 35, you're screwed. So, get up attacks generally are not worth it unless you know the opponent's going to hit. The other option, of course, is rolling on. Rolling varies from character to character, and they last 50 frames. The amount of time that you're invincible does vary, of course, again, from character to character, average being about 31. So you're invincible for about half the time, but there is, but let me see here. Towards the end of the roll, whoops, wrong option. So towards the end of the roll, like around there, that's when you can pretty much get hit right out of your roll. So if you know your opponent's going to be rolling onto the stage, you just wait till that time. And this is another good thing, if you want to study frames for any character, whenever you tap, that advances the game about 2 frames. 2 frames, 2 frames, 2 frames. And there we go. So, pretty much rolling from the ledge, it's kind of butts. I would not recommend it. Because what is nice, I guess, it's about right there. Alright. So, get up attack's gonna whiff, and on top of that, by standing there, you roll right in front of him. So, you can pretty much cover those two options just by standing right there. And of course, by doing that, you can cover all the other options as well. The other great options that you have from there, these are the two most, these next two are the most used. You have, of course, ledge jumping. This is one of my more favorite ones because this allows you to attack from the ledge, recover back fairly quickly. This also does one of my favorite setups from the ledge, which is, there. That will generally kill a good majority of the cast. That kills Captain Falcon, Dr. Mario, Little Mac, a lot of characters. That's one of my favorite ones. Oh yeah, if you get hit out of it, you're fucked. But that's why you don't do it unless you know you're gonna be able to hit the opponent, or it's gonna put you into a position where, you know, you have advantage on them. Cause some characters like this down air like this. That was interesting. Oh, and I'm never gonna be able to do that ledge jump again. Okay. The other one that we have. It's true. Alright, so the other one that we have, this is one of the more famous options. So regular getup. Alright. Reason why that option is really, really famous. So, the getting up from the ledge takes about, on average, about, according to my data, yeah, average about 33, 34 frames. every character, let's say it's 34 frames. They're invincible from frame 1 to 33, and then they have one frame of recovery, or then they could act. So pretty much they're invincible. So whenever you do a get up from the ledge like so, you only have a one frame window. They only have a one frame window to punish you. So when you get up from the ledge, you're only invincible like right then. It's pretty dumb. It's also a really, really hard option to cover majority of the time. Because, you know, you only have a single frame to get them. Just because they did that. The other one, of course, is what's really nice is the ledge jump. Ledge jumping is extremely fast. You're invincible for about 12 frames, and by the time you are out of there... Yes, jab does work. Sometimes. Oh yeah, that's generally when you want to do it. I'll be covering I'll be going over how to cover those later though. So then the other thing I want to cover about the ledge, but yeah, this one, jump, it's really, really good. This is generally the nicer option because not only are you in a spot where you can react, do pretty much almost whatever you want, you still have your double jump. And depending on like what's there, you can retreat back to the platform. If it's on FD, usually jump is not the best option. But like I was saying before, covering those options in particular. Hey, Ratsun25, thank you so much for coming to the stream with those kappas. But yes, generally standing right there covers a good majority of the options. Most of, at least when it comes to Fox, just most characters, most attacks will not be able to hit from this range. Or unless they put themselves in a very, very, very terrible position. And from there, of course, they can cover standard getup. Best way to do that, like, if you're really, really good, you can always do dash grab. So that's one, that one's hard. Grabs are generally only 7 frames. So if you want to be able to cover it, I would recommend throwing on a hitbox that lasts a long time. The way that you're able to cover the small frame windows is by throwing out giant hitboxes that overlap it. So if you only have one frame to cover, you overlap it with like 20 frames. So now you have a 20 frame window in which to hit it. The other thing that I would like to cover, but yeah, and so of course standing right there, it covers a good majority of options. Most characters will whiff their getup attack. If they roll right in front of you. If you predict they're gonna jump, you could of course still hit them. Let's see here. Oops. Because they will usually land about right there, about where that circle is. And usually your attack will be able to hit them out of it. Yeah, standing right there is always good, so... Just by literally standing right there, you cover all of the options that an opponent has from the ledge. And of course, you could apply a tremendous amount of pressure. Like, Sheik right now could probably F-tilt me. Actually, let's test that. Nope, that was not a forward tilt. Oh yeah, she could probably F-tilt from that range. Nope. Oh, she could probably do perfect pivot F-tilt. At the very least. Oh yeah, she could perfect pivot F-tilt in. At the very least. Alright, but yeah, like I said before, standing right there covers a good amount of options. They can't roll into you. They can't do standard getup. If they jump, you could try and cover that. They can't do getup attack because it's gonna whiff. And usually roll and getup attack are very, very punishable options. Like I said before, they last literally almost a whole second and have like 20-30 frames of lag. So you could easily cover both of those. Jump and regular get up, like I said before, they're hard. This one you have to time and tack almost right as they're getting up, and you only have like one frame to cover it. So, good luck with that. But this is the most used option in the game. By any pro, and anyone who is not trained to punish it, well, you know, they're screwed. You have almost a guaranteed way to get back up onto the ledge every single time. So the other option I want to cover is, I'm not sure if I can do it for you guys, so I'll see if I can emulate it. Oops. Okay. Alright, let's hold, grab, back throw, pause it. Alright, so she's recovering back. So this frame right here, so whenever you grab the ledge, remember that characters will get 22 frames of invincibility, so they're pretty much invincible as soon as they grab the ledge, which is very important. However, on the first two frames, you have the ability to knock them off every single time. Those two frames are always vulnerable, so you can go off and run at them with a back air. You can pretty much hit them whenever you want, but basically, whenever they grab the ledge, they're always vulnerable for the first two frames. I have a video of me spiking a Sheik out of Vanish with DK. I have a few videos of me back airing her. The other hard one to do is with Fox. You can down smash and stage spike her. And this applies with every character. Whenever a character grabs a ledge, they have two frames where they're not able to do anything. So, being able to train yourself in hitting those two frames, while it is really difficult, it's something that you really should practice if you want to be a great player. A lot of good players, they don't have that skill yet. There are some that do have the skill, and usually the ones that do have the skill are top tier players. So if you could acquire the skill, the ability to hit on that two frames. Yep. So if you could hit them during those two frames when they grab the ledge, you can knock them off every single time, especially with a move like, for example, Fox's down smash, where it would send them at a low angle like so. Like, I think it's about like a 0 degree angle. Yeah, it's about 0 degrees. And they'll just get knocked off every single time. Of course, you have to study up what characters can hit there. But like, for Fox, it's like down smash, forward smash, up tilt, up smash if the timing is right. You could also, of course, run off back air in this situation. But again, your timing does have to be on point, because you only have two frames where you can do that. So, that is the other thing that I wanted to cover. That's one of the big things that no one knows about the ledge. Kind of every character does have those two frames of vulnerability. Every single character in the game, like no matter who it is, they all have those two frames of vulnerability. So you can get them pretty much every single time. But yeah, see, and then they snap to the ledge. Oh, she chose the jump option. That's interesting. Covering those options will, in short, make you a much, much, much better player if you have the ability to cover those two or all those options, which can easily be done just by standing in the right location, which is about right here. By standing there, maybe with your back turn, depending on the character. Like if they roll here, up tilt. If they stay, if they do regular get up, 33 frames. Enough time for me to perfect pivot up tilt. Heck, maybe even forward smash. Forward smash is also a good option. They jump, You can read it with a back air. If they do regular getup, usually a character does have lag when they do the ledge jump. Not only that, they don't have their double jump, so of course if you hit them out of it, they're dead. Sort of. Or at the very least, you hit them out of it and then you can build up a whole bunch of percent. Usually characters like Shiki probably get better from it. Yeah, depending on the character. Yeah, Fox could also do it, which is really nice. That's insanely difficult. Oh, almost had it. But yeah, being able to do this will mark you as a top tier player for sure. If you have the ability to hit the opponent. Oh, almost had it. Yes, if you have the ability to do that. Again, it will mark you as one of the top tier players. Of course, the other thing that you can do when on the ledge, of course, is that's not true. I've down smashed Sheik off the ledge, so not all attacks have to go off to hit her. So that's not true at all. Sheik. Who was I gonna use for this example? Ah, yes. DK, any character with a good back air. A lot of characters with a good back air. So, the other option that I am going to be going over is ledge trumping. Oops, I'm terrible. Back throw. Oh, terrible on me. Let's go. So, whenever you grab the ledge, so pretty much only one character can be grabbing the ledge at a time. The second character that grabs onto it will be flung off. And of course, if you time it right, you can get a punish on it. So, sometimes you can get a nice, stronger punish, but yeah. After the, whenever you ledge trump somebody, if they're not prepared for it, they could, they'll get punished for it every single time. You can get a back air. Generally, you're going to be going for a back air. This is going to be the easier options. That's the easiest option, excuse me. However, it is fairly avoidable. And that's the other thing I want. If somebody tries to go for a ledge trump, you have the ability to avoid it every single time, 100% of the time. So, let's go over that. No! No! Okay. Back throw. Wait. Oh, damn it, I didn't switch it fast enough. Okay, and let's go to hold. Throw her off. Wait. And I think that's low enough. Oh, it's so hard in slow-mo. Okay. That's actually extremely hard in slow motion. I guess I'll do it normally. Nope, she jumps off. Anyways, one of the things that you can do. How am I gonna show this? Anyways, some of the ways that you could avoid a ledge trumping, fairly easy. So, first off, you have to be prepared for it. And let's say you both grab the ledge at the same time. It's really, really, really hard to emulate, I promise. No, I had it! Oh, actually, I could do one of her ledge trumping me. So generally, if you are the second one to grab the ledge... Where are you? Okay. Oh, she had no jump. Okay. Yes, if you are the second one to grab the ledge, what you can do... Let's chuck her off. She's gonna fall for a bit. So as you can see, she clearly grabbed the ledge, like, after me. So, she ended up getting launched off. Sucks for her. But... I'm gonna throw her off. So now I'm gonna be grabbing the ledge after her. Let's do that. Oops. No, I'm bad. Okay. Alright, there we go. Oh, did it way too early. So if the opponent does grab the ledge while you're still hanging onto it, if you guys pretty much grab at almost the same time. So if you've been holding onto it for a bit, you're gonna get popped off almost immediately. It's hard, it's really, really, really hard to emulate by myself. But yeah, if you are hanging onto the ledge all by yourself, and you've been hanging there for too long, you're gonna get popped off the ledge. Like so. However, if you both grab the ledge at the same time, and you know you're the one that grabbed it second, or you're the one that grabbed onto it first, and you're gonna be the one that gets trumped off, the best way to avoid it, you can do so by rolling. Buffering a roll is generally your best option, and that is what you should do if you know somebody is gonna be going for the ledge trump every single time. It's a very, very reliable option. For example, like right there, if someone knows I'm gonna be grabbing the ledge, which from here, when DK is doing its little upbeat, whoops. If the DK was good, he would be going there and immediately going to the ledge afterwards. If he was good, which I'm not. But, unless he's gonna be grabbing the ledge, and if you know he's gonna grab the ledge, go for a ledge trump. Why not? See if you could do it. But most of the pros, once they grab the ledge, since they know they're gonna be getting ledge trump when they grab it, they see the animation, they see the second person jump, and then you could just tap the shoulder button, roll yourself right back onto the stage immediately. And that is right there, that's your best option. That's pretty much your only option from there. Otherwise, if you do end up getting trumped, it's three cheeks. We don't need three cheeks. Oh, it's too far for her. I'm surprised. Chuck. So if you do... Oh no. Didn't do it right. So if you do end up being the one getting tossed, you do have the ability to actually DI it. Every single time. You could actually DI the trump. You can DI it up and away, up and away, away, down and away. Depending on the character, I believe down and away is one of the safer options that you would like to choose, that you should choose when getting popped off the ledge. By choosing down and away, they will not be able to give you any guaranteed follow-ups when trying to attack you. That's super important, because now DK can't back air you if you messed up the buffer, the ledge buffer. being able to overcome getting ledge trumped every single time is a very powerful option. Because ledge trumping is legit. It's alright. It's a good way to overcome weaker players with less knowledge. But that's not, it's not a good way to take all the stronger players. The stronger players, of course, will know the options, that if they do manage to get trumped, they can do up and away, down and away, away, depending upon the character. Or, if they know that you're gonna ledge trump them, they're just gonna buffer the roll to immediately get themselves back onto the stage every single time. And... I believe that is a... but when you get the ledge trump, it's almost always a guaranteed follow-up. Man, I cannot do it on this side of the stage. It's almost always a guaranteed follow-up. You don't even have to wait for their jump. You could actually catch them out of their jump if they try to do it. So. And generally, you could back air them before they're even able to do anything. Actually, they won't be able to air dodge. They won't be able to do much. But of course, if they DI properly, they'll be able to be put into a position where you will not be. Well, you will not be able to get any follow ups whatsoever. And that's generally the best thing to do when you get trumped off of the ledge. This is just DI correctly. Yeah, you could wait for their double jump, but that's very, very, very risky. Because not only that, characters will probably not need to use their double jump. If you get popped off, wait until they're down here, and die. Like that. But, let's see, let's say they get popped off. Of course, they could just air dodge. Double jump, and then recover from really, really low. They don't even have to double jump high. That's also the mistake of a lot of players, double jumping high to get back onto the, directly back onto the stage. It's not needed. If they just go right back to the ledge, it's a good option. And then of course the other thing that you can do once you have, of course getting ledge trumped is still really, really bad. Of course, characters like Sheik, Donkey Kong, they're able to back air them. For other characters, though, that have really, really poor follow-ups off of, for their back air, it'd be possible to get footstooled if you pop someone off the ledge. Like, if you DI towards him, double jump, but that's too fast for it. Yeah, you know, I would not wait for someone's percent, or, let's see here. Could it be possible to get footstooled if you pop someone off of the ledge? No! That's impossible. Because when you do pop somebody off the ledge, they're actually put into a reeling animation. And when they're in that reeling animation, you actually are not able to do anything. That's a good example. Oops. As you can see right there, she had to wait for a little bit. She couldn't immediately double jump. See, I couldn't do anything until that double jump, and I was spamming double jump the entire time, right there. So, if I can't even do jump, which is like 2 frames, there's no way in hell I'm gonna be double jumping like anytime soon, because you saw that entire time. While I was being launched off of the stage, I could not do a single thing. Uh-oh, she's dead. Damn it, she. Actually, let's have her walk. Get over here, because I'm too lazy. Let's do the 1.4. And fixed. Actually, to make it faster. Half speed. And let's turn this off. She could recover from there. Sheik. Alright, so, as you can see, I'm getting launched off the stage. And I'm in that animation. Yeah, because then Yoshi, well, Yoshi's an exception. Yoshi could double jump back on with his super arm and just be like, oh, I'm Yoshi. Nothing you could do except footstool. You could actually footstool, Yeah, poor Yoshi. But yeah, with Yoshi, actually, from what I recall, no one's ever done it, and I actually need to apply this more. You should be able to footstool him out of his double jump. And that's a mechanic that's been around since Brawl, so careful. And mechanics and footstools are starting to become more prominent every single time. They're starting to become way more prominent. So, but yeah, as you can see right there, the moment that I got launched off of the stage, I was not able to react for a long, long, long period of time. So, and on top of that is the last thing that I wanted to cover when it came to the ledge. As you guys know, you get invincibility for 122 frames of grabbing the ledge. If grabbed again, you're done. You get no more invincibility until the next time you touch the stage. When you touch the stage, oops. Oh, and I guess, that's right. If you hang on for too long, you're gonna drop off. That right there is pretty obvious. It takes a while, though, for a character to drop off the stage. Damn! No, he should be. Why? He should be able to make that. Hold on, I'm salty. He should be able to make that. Oh, that's right. This is Town and City. He could actually make that on the Smashville side, which is hilarious. Okay. But yeah. When you grab the ledge, if you grab the ledge a second time, you get no invincibility, and of course you use the options that you normally do, are pretty much going to be guaranteed the entire time. So, avoid grabbing the ledge two times in a row if you can. Try to do that consciously. The other way that you could force the option is if you ledge trump somebody. Oh, she died. Anyways, if you ledge trump a character, they're forced off of the stage. From there, if you think about it, their only option is to go back onto the stage or grab the ledge. If they do either of those, they're in vulnerable positions where you're able to hit them out. Of course, they can still do all their attacks, but if they grab the ledge, they're vulnerable and you can hit them off. So, if they land on the stage, well, you know, they're still vulnerable and they're up in the air, which is a terrible position to be in Smash. Being up there is bad. Just in general, you can get up tilted out and you're only limited to, like, what, six or ten options. 11 if you count your double jump, but then that's expendable. So, being ledge trumped is terrible. That's why whenever you go onto the stage, always try to buffer an option. It doesn't even have to be roll, it can be anything. Roll is one of your best options. Wait, what about attacks? Because generally, if you go for the ledge again, you're screwed. They could generally hit you out of it, and when you grab onto the ledge, you're stuck onto that ledge grab animation for a specific period of time. You can't immediately let go of it. It takes about 22 frames. Yeah, you could do that, and then up B. Help stall you out onto the ledge. Feeling cheeky. But generally, oh no, am I dead? Yeah, I'm dead. Not what I want. Generally, you do not want to, once you get the ledge jumped off, their only option, like I said before, either grab the ledge, land onto the stage. They can attempt to knock you off like that, but do that, all you gotta do is just wait here. What are they gonna do? They're not too many attacks. I could go from here onto the stage reliably. I mean, there's Diddy Kong's barrels, but there's all those options are not safe. There's a lot of unsafe options in the game. Not from my knowledge. Yeah, not from my knowledge. His, the things for DK is that his grounded up B has super armor on the first few hits. What do you mean? What are you talking about, Vinny? Oh, to gain height? Yeah. DK gains pretty much none. Thing is though, his horizontal recovery on it's actually really ridiculous. So the best way to do it with DK is you hover out there for a bit and then you go in. That's the best way. Cause then you can stall out here for a little bit and then you go in. Once you're comfortable. But that's like the only way. So yeah, that's like the only way to recover well with Donkey Kong. And of course he could get caped out of it too, which is terrible. No, we should be able to recover that. That's stupid. But yeah. I think that covers pretty much all of the options from the ledge. So I guess to go over it really quickly. Attacking from the ledge, rolling from the ledge, generally those are terrible options. The roll is and the better options, of course, is ledge jumping. There is a, hold on, let me get it from the YouTube list. There is one video out there that's, essentially hack stashing. Or hack stashing? Yeah, hack stashing. You know, like, pretty much wave dashing from the ledge. There is an option like that, and it immediately goes into a full run once you hit the stage. I have to try to find it really quick, so give me a second, guys. Mechanics, easy trick. Edge cancels. Edge grabbing, air dodge cancel applications. Dare cancel. Ooh, that one's a fun one, actually. Dare cancels. Oh yeah, Ido's MK combo video. That was actually really lovely. You guys should look that up. It's just called MK combo stuff by Ito L6. Tips on ledge safety. Oh, where was it? It was a really, really big video, I think. Just that no one really was able to look into it. Oh, where was it though? Edge cancel? Here we go. And let me put this here. I'll give the video for you guys real quick. You guys want to take a look at that? The video pretty much illustrates. So here we have Marth. He grabs the ledge. He ledge jumps and then he suddenly is able to just run instantly onto the stage. I have no idea how he does it. I'll put the. So as you can see right there, that's ridiculous. That's actually absolutely ridiculous that he's somehow able to do that. And the thing is, the Wario boards have been able to find out how to do something like that with Wario, of course. But that involves using his bike and the momentum that you gain from jumping off of it. This one, however, just shows him double jumping and immediately running onto the stage. How it's performed, I really, really don't know. I wish I knew. It's something that still has not been found out yet. No. I mean, if you watch the video, he does drop from the ledge, double jump, but the oops, I have a wrong control of my hand. I've done it a couple times with Fox too. It's not character specific. Might be stage specific. I don't really know. Oh, it was on Town City, wasn't it? Either way, thing is, he double jumped from there. If you watch the video, Vinny, he double jumps from that point. Otherwise, the double jump circle would have to be literally down here. And even then, as you can see, that's a little too much height. From having to do it really, really far down. He, however, as you can see right there, the double jump circle, as indicated right there by Marth, starts at that point. And at that point, he is able to jump immediately and dash onto the stage. Even if I were to fast fall right now. Oh, thank God, that's why I'm not DK. Okay, but you saw right there, even when I fast fall, and you can only fast fall at the very, very peak of your jump, he was not able, you know, it didn't happen. It didn't happen. So I'm like, what's going on? Even if I were to fast fall it, see right there, you can only fast fall at the very, very peak of your jump. Like you were saying, so see? He was able to do that immediately into a dash onto the stage. I have no idea how it's done. There's like yeah, and it still fools a lot of people. Because it's not a jump from low into a dash like that. And it's not fast fall onto the stage either. Let's see. Watching the video, he drops. He immediately ledge drops and then immediately goes into a dash. Once he double jumps onto the stage. Once he does a double jump. So, grab the ledge. Drops down a little bit, double jumps, and then immediately goes into a dash across the stage. No one still knows how it works. I've actually tried doing a lot of research on it, and I've found nothing. Video days from 2014. Has it been patched? Nope. No patches. I've kept up with all the patches. And they only work on character frame data. Character frame data, yeah, they pretty much only work with frame data. They have patched out a few other glitches, but that was not one of them. It was not one of the glitches that has been patched out. Plus, we don't even know how it's done. So how can they even patch it out if they don't even have, like, the inputs? So. Yeah, that's something that I still would love to be informed of, if it was patched out or not. or if it's still in the game, how do you even do it? Because there's stuff like, you know, like perfect pivoting. Like, this is actually kind of game-breaking. Because, you know, you could do that. And allow your character to pretty much be moving while throwing out attacks. So, good luck. Try looking up, like, and as you can see, you saw the video, Vinny. Look up, there's not really too much input on it. Like, if you watch the I've watched the video over and over again. Grab the ledge, let's go, double jumps, and immediately runs on. I don't know how it's done. And that's actually very game-breaking, because if he does a foxtrot onto the stage, that means you can, straight from the ledge, you can perfect pivot onto the stage. And that is essentially going to be next level of hacks of, that's pretty much going to be Smash 4's version of hacks dashing. So, that is one of the that's another option involving the ledge that is completely unfound. No one's found it. We found, like, a few hints of it, but never figured out the first part, which is how to get the immediate run onto the stage. If you can get the immediate run onto the stage, and then if you could learn how to do that, then if you know how to perfect pivot, you could go immediately from the ledge, perfect pivot onto the stage, and now you have perfect control. Watch the video, he does it from really, really, really high up. So, again, and it's, and there's no peak, there's no fast falling, there's none of that. It just goes immediately from the ledge, let go, jump, or dash onto the stage. So, if again, if we could figure that out, on top of doing that into a perfect pivot, just get so much control. You get so much control. Yes, it will not have the invincibility, but that is, I think that's going to be a much safer option than rolling onto the stage, attacking. It won't be able to replace ledge attacks, regular get up, or actually it might even be able to replace regular get up, because once you do that, because going from here, you will immediately transfer to this position right there, and of course being able to go in. I don't know, that's it beats me what he's trying to do. Because I've watched that video multiple times. It's not a B move. It's not air dodging. It's not double jump. And even if you ever dodge into the ledge, you're screwed. So. Right, I'm just gonna let that option. Wait, what? I hold on, I think I found something. Sorry about me not doing anything for a minute. It's about here. Did you see that? Did you see that though? It... How did I do that? So, I did it, just now. I don't know how, but I did it. again. I don't know how that was done, but if that could be done without the air dodge, because that felt like I could have done it without air dodging. No, it's not that either. Yeah, no. Horimon, and thank you so much for... I'll type now. Thank you so much for post. Anyways, guys, it's 8 p.m. So, anyways... I hope you guys have learned a lot, though. I definitely have. I know that there's a lot that you can dash from the ledge. I just have no idea how. But yeah, once that... Oh, man. Yeah, once that mystery pretty much gets figured out, we'll have another incredibly strong option on our hands. So, I'm gonna go eat. I actually have not eaten all day, so I am famished. So, alright guys, thank you so much for joining the stream, and I will be seeing all of you later.